Hello YouTube, Sakuku Blitz here, coming up to part 16 of my Orcs Must Die 5 Skull Nightmare difficulty video walkthrough. Today's episode, we'll be taking on the library, where we'll be introduced to the Swinging Mace, which I still argue is probably one of the best traps in the entire game and well worth its price tag. In this particular level, there's three very specific points they want you to use it on, so make sure to use it right there. I'm going to go with this trap layout because I've been enjoying a decoy too much.
Hello?
You have chosen well.
I'm going to do that.
This will help.
Where am I now? Ah, the library, where the Order stores 10,000 years collectively.
They're breaking through! Mind.
Nope, nothing useful.
I'm just gonna do it like that. And I'm going to back up, because this entire round is all about orc archers. So I'm just gonna back up and snipe them with my lightning ring for easy kills. Oh, that wasn't on the coin forge. There's about 16 archers, so the round itself is very easy.
Is that all you got?
That's all. Yeah, that is all they got. So I'm gonna put that up there. And put that up. Not over there, but over here.
Ooh, here's a good one.
And start setting up an archer barricade. Or a barricade to shut them into there.
Clean up on aisle three.
So, yeah. Oops, I killed them. I'm gonna try to aggro as many of them as possible. And keep them on the coin forge. And blast them like that. Oh my gosh. Aim! There we go. Aim! Okay. This round is where things start getting a bit more chaotic. Because that door behind me is about to open, and an orc wants to come in and do bad things to the apprentice. So for now, I'm going to go... You know, I'm going to help clear out this wave a little bit by shooting those off. And here comes the ogre. I'm gonna start headshotting him. And start putting down a thunderstorm. To help handle ogres, or have handle the orcs as they come. And just kite the flaming ogre on here. And handle that leak, handle that leak. Oh. Wow, that could have been very bad. Going to now do this and put that up like that because I need to handle these kobolds. And that should handle everything that's coming. I'm gonna try to nuke them as they come, but unfortunately I continue to demonstrate I have incredibly bad aim. And that doesn't. And I have no leaks. That takes care of that. I'm not gonna get trap linkage. Once again, I'm using my decoy trap linkage spell magnification strategy. The one fundamental flaw about this entire strategy is the fact that you have one huge startup cost to it. So, make sure to capitalize on as much on coin forge kills as you can with Lightning Storm, because that will help maximize your, help recover the amount of cash you get back for a magic kill. Now I just gotta deal with a lot of archers and a lot of orcs coming out that way. So I'm gonna put up another Lightning Storm and start getting as many shields off as I can. While blasting as many archers as I can, pick up this pump potion because it is useful. It is good for my life. And now start blowing archers away. Trying to blow archers away and failing. Okay, so now I have those kill zones set up. I'm going to set up something very similar right there. Once I get the money too. And for now, I'm just going to put some more holes into these shields with my crossbow. And I'm going to put up another lightning storm. And start blasting everything I can. Another lightning storm, and there goes my decoy. Put up another decoy. Let them have fun with it, and blast them away. I'm gonna put a mace up there. I'm gonna double up like that. And do that just to finish it off. Two fire ogres coming into play. And a shaman. Okay, kill the shaman. Okay, shaman is dead. Last thing we need is one of these flaming ogres to be upgraded. Oh boy, bad. That takes care of that. But yeah, shamans can resurrect, so make sure they don't get. Make sure you kill the shaman before you kill anything else in that entire southern wave. And I'm gonna set ballista, and I'm gonna get some trap. I'm actually gonna get some life because I'm confident my decoy and my trap will handle everything for now. Okay, that's enough for now. I don't need any much more than this. A lightning storm over here. Oops, wrong. Pretty much this entire northern wave can now be stunted by this one very narrow trap zone. Get him out of the way. I'm not gonna put the thunderstorm up there. And yeah, that takes care of that. Bribes don't like that. And two more ballistas right there. Wave 9 out of 10. I'm basically set up now. Very few things will be able to get through what I have set up. Especially on the northern side, especially since they're all archers. So I'm just going to handle here, like that. And yeah, like I said, the problem about the strategy is that there's a very large upfront cost to it. So it's definitely not for every level, especially if they overwhelm you. They overwhelm you very quickly. So like this is not an ideal level for. I'm not exactly sure why I'm doing it, to be perfectly fair. Honestly, if you set it up like how this is set up, right here on all three corridors, you're pretty much going to kill them all. Maybe put a couple of brimstone in front and behind to help deal with shields. But yeah. I'm going to do that to shoot the things over there. And I'm not going to put lightning storm in and deal with more shamans. And now I have a flaming ogre, which, thankfully, died by decoy. Another decoy's coming up. Another thunderstorm on the table. Yeah, there's a lot of ogres this level. So I'm gonna set another one right there. And set another thunderstorm. And then put another one right there. Yeah, they'll get caught up on the decoys. And then they will die. Like so. So yeah, there you go, that's the library. I hope you enjoyed yourself, and I'll see you next episode. Take care, and have a good day. Peace out.